Baldwin County, Alabama. We're under a tornado alert. Water levels are pretty high. You'll notice that little dock over there. You can see that the water is right up to the dock. Same way up here at the So anyway, I left out at 2:30 this morning, drove all the way down here, worked on the boat all day, had it anchored. I got here and I could not believe what I saw. I saw all these boats parked in here. South, but they had these boats in here one after another, and it's funny because everybody lined up like I did. Which is exactly sideways to the wind. The only thing that I can hope for is that this tree coverage right here will block those 90 mile an hour winds that are going to be coming in here, because they are coming in here at 90 miles an hour, because Baldwin County and Mobile is right there at the northeastern sector of this hurricane that's going to be coming in here in probably about a couple hours. And it's not going to be pretty. And I'm staying on the boat. Yeah. Hello, hello, hello. So anyway, this is my first live broadcast that I've done. And I'm totally new to it. I don't even know how to figure that. I can't figure all this stuff out. But I don't even know if there's a chat function on this thing. I have no idea how many people are watching or if there's a chat function. I'm doing this for my phone. Oh, okay, here we go. 96-1, the Rock with Van Halen inside a six-pack. Stayed on top. Corgis says good evening. Category 1 hurricane. Hello, Donna Rice. On the eastern side of Nate, or the dirty side, as they like to say, we will have tornadoes. Yes, they are tied up good. If I could zoom this up. They've got them kind of like in a V pattern. They've got them V-ing off the bow, and then they've got them V'd off and tied to the trees back here in the back, as like I do. Oh my God, look, there's a dolphin. Let's see if it'll come up again. Incredible. See him? Hot dog. That's got to be a good sign, doesn't it? Where'd he go? I don't know where he went. That was the coolest thing. But anyway, like I said, the water level here is probably up about 4 feet, and I think it's going to come up a lot higher than that. A lot of these people's docks are right even with the water. Some of them are under the water. If you can, let me see if I can zoom up. Do this, but you can see, I don't know if y'all can see this or not, but that dock is underwater actually. By the way, how am I coming in? Is this coming in okay? I'm on a phone. This is my iPhone. Is it broadcasting okay? But right now there's a little wind. You can see it right at the top of the trees. But it's I don't know, occasionally we get gusts maybe to 20 miles an hour, something like that. It's probably what it's doing right now. Oh, is the music drowning it out now? I'm up here at the helm, and I've got my speakers. I secure my little dinghy. I'll walk out here and see if I can get some pictures of the docks over there. See if I can zoom up. Yeah, the water surge they're going to have a pretty good problem with. I had to get somebody to come pick up my car and take it. But if you'll notice, all those docks over there are actually underwater. The parts that you walk on, most of them are underwater right now. And I'm sure it's going to get a lot worse as time goes on. I think the worst of it is going to hit probably midnight tonight. So I'm going to be hanging out in the boat. And I've got a cooler full of ice and drinks. And I've got all the food I need. And get ready to put fenders out if I need to. If these boats start coming in on me, I just hope that in the morning we don't have a big sailboat sandwich with all the sailboats just packed together up against the bank over there. But hopefully not. Flip it around so y'all can see. That dolphin was incredible. Let me see if I can read some of these. Well, I actually took the sail down. There's no Genoa sail here. I've taken it off. It's inside the cabin. This sail I have strapped up really well, because usually what happens is the wind, if it's blowing really hard, it'll get in that lazy jack and it'll actually raise the sail, and then next thing you know, it'll catch the sail and shoo, your boat's underway. So everybody likes to strap them down. Notice over here they've all strapped theirs down. If I can zoom this, all right. But if you'll notice, everybody's got theirs strapped down too. That's a common problem in high winds, which we're expecting 90 mile an hour winds. But I don't know if y'all know this or not, but most marinas, whenever there's a named storm or hurricane coming in, which is a named storm, they make you move your boat. I mean, you've got to take your boat out. So that's the reason why Pirate's Cove is evacuated. I see there is a sailboat over there, and there is one other boat, but everybody had to move their boats out today. So I guess everybody just goes out and finds a place to anchor, or some place they figure is going to be safe, and just ride it out. Of course, all these sailboats, nobody's on them. I think I'm the only idiot that's gonna ride this thing out. Any questions? I'm amazed. This is my first live stream. It's kind of neat. For a while there, I couldn't get the thing to crank up. I was like, what the devil's going on here? And finally, I got it to work. And of course, I knew I said I was going to start it at 3:30, and I like to be prompt. But anyway, I got my dinghy leaks fixed. So there's the dinghy. It's not real pretty, but it's holding air. And this is a cute little cove. There was a guy, Mike, who was out here fishing the other day. He caught like 4 or 5 sea trout right out of here. You can see the wind up at the top of these trees. But I imagine tonight it's going to get a little bit disturbing with 90 mile an hour winds moving in. I don't know what that's going to be like, but I'm going to have to break my fenders out probably and put them on the sides of this boat just in case some of these boats break free and come over. Well, the solar panels, no, they actually stay on. They're not going to call. If they were sitting up this way, yeah, they pose a pretty big problem, but they're pretty much in line with the wind, and the wind's just going to scoot right over them, so they're not really a problem. And those panels really work well. Both my alternators on my engines are out. I've ordered new alternators. And the only thing that's keeping the batteries powered is the solar panels, and they're doing a fantastic job. Oh, I doubt if it's gonna flip. This thing's pretty heavy. Let me tell you what happened on a sail back from, I don't know if y'all saw the episode where I was coming back from Tampa, but anyway, I had the captain up there at the helm, and it was during the afternoon. It was his shift, and he had a, let me switch this around. Anyway, he had a panoramic camera that took pictures as a wave came across, and there was one rogue wave that came across. It must have been 20 feet high, and it came and it hit. And instead of picking the thing up and flipping it, the boat's so heavy that it just kind of stayed in place, went up a little bit, and then the wave just washed right over the top of it. And he's got some pictures of that. I was going to put it on the episode, but he never would email me the pictures. I saw the pictures, and I was like, holy mackerel, because the waves just went right over the top of the boat. I was down there sleeping. I remember popping up once, but... you know, when you do these things, you hit all these waves, and you just learn to sleep with when you have a chance, basically. The heck with the bumps, get some sleep. It's getting there. It's getting there, Donna. It's, let me see what all I've done. I took the reason why this sail's off is because I took it down and got it fixed. Some of the seams came undone, and the the outside part where the sun protection part of it had to be redone. I did that, and it's in really good shape. It cost me about $400 something, but it's in good shape, and I haven't put it up yet. And the mainsail is in really good shape. This lazy jack right here really needs to be patched or redone. It's got a hole in it. Let me see if I can show you. Yeah, it's got a hole right there. And of course it's been patched here and there, but that's lazy jacks. All that does is just whatever you lower your sail, it just falls right down in there. And it's kind of nice to have that. But they don't cost that much. I could have a new one put on there. But it's not bothering me at this point. And what else have I done? Oh, on the inside, I've got a new refrigerator. I've got a freezer. The engine, I was putting the engine together. I started putting the engine together yesterday. And, I didn't know one flipped in Honduras. Anyway, I started to put the engine together yesterday, and the machine shop had vatted the engine, and it ate the cam bearings out of it. It didn't have any cam bearings, so now I have to order the cam bearings. And the machine shop said that they were going to put them in for me for free. And so I took the block back to Novelty Machine Works, and they're going to, as soon as I get the cam bearings, they're going to put them in there for me free. So I've got them on order, and the engine's coming along. I've got all the parts except for the cam bearings that I didn't know I was missing the cam bearing. And shouldn't be too long. As soon as I get those parts, I can put it back together in about a day. But yeah, I've been up since 2 o'clock this morning, and boy, it was a brutal drive coming down here. Of course, it was calm, there wasn't any traffic, and it was a really nice drive, but it was just tough trying to stay awake when you're used to sleeping. And then of course when I got here, it was quite a job to try to get the boat loaded and get everything tucked away and get the anchor set right. And of course all these people were out here, and I said, oh no, I can't turn the boat the direction I want to. I wanted to face the boat into the wind, which would have put this boat at a complete 90 degree angle from what the other boats beside me are. Boy, I'm hearing some thunder. There's fixing to be some bad stuff coming in. I just hope that I'll be able to do another live broadcast. Donna, it doesn't show me how many people are watching. How many people are watching? It shows I'm getting a good signal here. Anyway, I'm going to flip this around so y'all can see the scenery here. And maybe we'll get lucky and a dolphin will pop up or something interesting will happen. But the sky is starting to get really dark and I can hear the wind starting to pick up. Okay, so I have 7 people. Well, that's great. I ought to pop back on about 12 o'clock at night and let y'all see what it's like to be in a boat with 90 mile an hour winds. Woo! It should be pretty scary. I think I might do that. I think I might just go live at about, let me see. The worst of it's supposed to be here at 12 midnight. I might go live about 12:15 and just let everybody catch a glimpse of what it is in the thick of it, if I'm still here. Oh boy. Yep, here's what it's like. Well, you know, I thought it was a good thing that Nate was going into, they said the eye was going to go into the mouth of the Mississippi. And I figure, well, if it's going to do that, that means I'm about 175 miles away. I mean, my gosh, I can't possibly. But then I heard on the news that Baldwin County is right in the worst part of that northeastern sector that's got all that high wind. So I'm like, oh, wonderful. Now I get to get hit with this stuff. Hey, I could do that. I could just take a video of it. Oh, sorry about the thing. I do that all the time. If you'll notice in some of my movies, whenever I'm shooting, I always let my finger hangs right over. I don't know where that lens is, and I have my finger hanging right over it. And I go, why do I do this all the time? But I'm learning. I'm learning this. I'm totally new at all this. I'm amazed that I can figure out how to do this live feed. That's interesting. Anyway, this is really a pretty little cove in here. And I was really shocked this morning when I saw all these boats. I was the only boat out here for a couple of weeks. And this morning when I got in here, man, it was just boom, 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 boom. I mean, they were just one after another. I'm a little worried about this one and this one. They had a guy that was rode by in a little dinghy, and he was taking pictures of all these boats. He said, as he was riding by, he said, "I'm taking pictures for insurance reasons." I'm thinking, yeah, I hope tomorrow we don't have a big sailboat sandwich. But anyway, this is about all there is to it. I was expecting a lot of wind right about now. I was expecting at least 35, 40 knots. And maybe it is up a little higher, but right down here is not too bad. I think this cove is going to break a lot of that wind. I don't know if I'll really feel a lot of wind, but I'm going to record it, and I'll put it on an episode for us. And how much time I got? I got a 30 minute. This is a 30 minute live feed, and I've got 7 more minutes. So if anybody has any questions, just fire them at me. I'll start reading them. Yeah, I'm gonna put my bumpers out. Yeah, I think so. I think we're all tied up pretty well here. Yeah, you know, I'm glad you mentioned that, Donna. I'm going to show you this. There's the trees, and I'm just far enough away. Of course, it looks like I'm really close, but I am actually far enough away to where if that tree were to fall, the tallest trees were to fall, they'd probably hit about 10 feet behind me. So I'm safe from that. And actually, that was one of my concerns. I thought about just bringing my boat and pulling it in as close to the shore. Actually, I was going to turn it around and just drive it right up, put the pontoons right up on the bank. And then I was going to take some lines and just secure it off on the trees on the right and left side. I thought that might be the best route to go. But then I started thinking about it. I said, well, if the trees fall down, like you said, I'm going to be in pretty bad shape. Although these stays right here that I have my hand on, these would deflect the tree from just crashing down on it. Power lines? No, I don't. There's no power lines. All right, I think I might do that around 12:15 tonight, when it's supposed to be at the worst. I think I probably will just pop it on live, just to let y'all see what's going on. But I haven't had much sleep. I hope I can get at least a few hours sleep before 12 tonight, because I am going to be absolutely dead tired. You know, one of the hardest things with this catamaran is putting this dadgum rope out. If you'll notice, there's an anchor rope. You know, people always get mad at me because I say rope. They say, They say, if you're a sailor, they're called lines. They're all lines. All right. Okay. This anchor line here attaches to the main, to the chain. And what that does is it distributes the weight off of the main chain. You've got to actually let enough out to where it hangs down. And then you've got this connected where it V's out. I don't know if y'all can see where it V's out. Well, there's one going down, there's the other one. And it's hooked to that main chain, and it distributes the weight between the two pontoons, which is really nice. And otherwise, you jerk your windlass right out of the box. And then, of course, I've got another anchor out there. That's what's tied here. I've got another one, and this one goes way out there. I've got it probably 200 feet. It's out there in about the center of this channel. And the reason I put that there is because if this thing broke free and it started getting crazy in here, I was going to just pull my boat out to the middle and just let it windmill and keep it away from all these other boats. Was one of the plans. I think I will. I've got three more minutes. I've scheduled the time from, it looks like we got a patrol out here. I scheduled time from 3:30 to 4, so I might as well use my whole total allotted time. And I think this is the Baldwin County patrol right here. It's nice that they're out here checking. Yeah, you know, that's exactly what I thought. I said, man, I told him, I said, look, anything that's wound like that is rope to me. I mean, I just don't see how you can call that line. You know, fishing line, you know, one strand of something is a line to me. But they say that they'll let you know real fast whether you're a sailor. They know if you're a sailor or not if you start calling everything rope. Oh, I don't think they don't mind if you're on the boat. The only thing that hurts people in these surges is being in their house, the house flooding, and them getting trapped in a position like that. If you're on the boat just rises with the water and you're fine. Wow, I'm actually amazed that it's this calm. Of course, you can see those clouds moving pretty fast. I don't know if y'all can notice that across the tops of the trees, but those clouds are spinning pretty fast. It gives you a pretty good little indication of where the eye is on this thing, because you can see the rotation of those clouds. Yeah, those clouds are moving pretty fast up there. Yeah, they're definitely moving about 35, 40 knots up a little higher. I think this little cove is actually protecting us here with the winds. Okay. I think it's close to time to check out. Let me get around here where I can see everybody. Oh, there y'all are. Anyway, all right, folks, I am going, it's 30 minutes is up. I am going to go in there and get me a quick nap and set my alarm clock for about 11:30. And I will pop up and give y'all the skinny on what's going on. All right, thank you. Thank you for the lug. I need it. This first time I've ever rode one of these out, but I feel pretty confident. These Lagoon 440s are built like tanks. I mean, they're like fiberglass tanks. Anyway, thank y'all for watching. I sure appreciate y'all joining the channel. And if you can, make a donation to the engine overhaul. It's just click on it. It's anything, $1, $5, whatever. Thank you, Donna. All right, goodbye, y'all.